Now, Tolkien never lived to see any of these films, and it's frankly impossible to gauge what he would have thought of them, but we know a little bit about what he might think of animated movies based on his work in general. Kind of. In his life, Tolkien seemed to be of multiple minds regarding potential filmed adaptations altogether, but especially animated adaptations. In general, he was open to a filmed adaptation, but he was not convinced it could actually work. As for animation specifically, in a 1957 letter, number 198 in the Letters of J.R.R. Tolkien collection, Tolkien wrote, "I should welcome the idea of an animated motion picture with all the risk of vulgarization." So, at least at that time, he was open to the idea of a cartoon, but fully prepared for it to be a disappointment. But later in the early 70s, when John Boorman was working on his never-produced version of the film, Boorman claims Tolkien was relieved that it would be live-action, saying that he had a nightmare that it would be animated. Based on the other things I've heard about the Boorman script, whether it was live-action or animated should have been the least of Tolkien's worries. But that's a different story. The thing is, at the time, it made a lot of sense for these to be animated. The Hobbit was seen as a children's fantasy adventure tale, the likes of which Disney built an empire out of, and Lord of the Rings was seen as practically unfilmable. For two distinct reasons. Reason number one, the scale. And reason number two, the scale. By that I mean reason number one, the scale of the story, the scope, the grand overwhelming world of Middle-earth, full of massive armies and cities rich with their own history. And reason number two, the physical scale of the different characters of Middle-earth, the diminutive hobbits and dwarves alongside the larger-than-life elves, wizards, and Dunedain. With animation, you don't have the limitations of live action. You can draw characters of any shape and size, and as many of them as you need, and put them in any exotic locale you can imagine. Let's put a pin in that thought, and for now, let's look at these movies individually, starting with Rankin Bass's The Hobbit.